Hello, mate.
Hello there.
Can I help you?
No, I'm beyond help.
Oh, okay. No, I didn't know if you was coming in.
No.
What can we do for you, mate?
Don't do anything for me.
Okay, what are you taking pictures of?
Anything I can see.
For any specific reason?
Yeah, everything has a specific reason.
Yeah, we know that. It's just that this is a military establishment.
Oh, is it? Oh, sorry, I thought you were three bushes.
So
what are you saying? I know it's in a military establishment, so what are you saying?
What I'm saying is we'd just like to know if there's any security implications while you're taking pictures of it.
Well, what about my right to privacy?
Well, what about them?
Well, you'd like to know something, but it's private. So where do we go from here? See you later.
Sorry, I'm just going to call the police, that's all.
Oh. You tell them to hurry up?
Yeah, just wait there.
Okay. Can I have your details, please, seeing as you've approached me?
No.
Aren't you supposed to identify if you approach a member of the public?
No. You're approaching me, not I'm approaching you.
Oh, I thought you three come to the gate. I must be hallucinating. Was it bring your dog to work day, is it? Thought you were supposed to protect our rights, not snitch on us.
Well, it's just as well as not the telegram with the gun, isn't it?
Of the compound in that?
Yeah.
Has anyone spoke to you about it?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, that's not a problem. Because everybody gets a bit paranoid. Sorry?
Who's you told? You just took one, you hypocrite. Here's another one. I don't know, but I've been told if it wasn't in the army, I'd be on the dole. Oh, there's a police car. They got a van for me, oh no. I did have plans for today. And tonight.
go up there. I'll cross the road to push him off.
Over now. Then he'll come down that way. That's piss him off no end. Hurry up! It's an emergency! Hello, what's the emergency?
I seem to have a chat with you, sir.
What's the emergency?
Sorry?
What's the emergency?
Say that again, sir.
What's the emergency?
The emergency is that somebody's been taking some photos of the military.
Oh my God, no way. Is that a crime?
Sorry, sir?
Can I have your details, please?
You can have my details, sir. That's not a problem.
What's your name?
Just so you know, sir, my body-worn camera is...
Good man, well done.
Time.
Right.
Okay, it's 7880. That's all I need to tell you at this stage,
sir. You don't want to give me your name, no?
No, I don't. I'm not required
okay.
to, sir.
Well, then don't be asking mine for any point, then, okay?
Okay.
Right, what do you want to say?
That's really how it works, sir, isn't it?
Come on. Shit or get off the pot. What have you got to say?
There's no need to swear, is there? Because we're in a public place, and I don't expect you to swear.
Shit's not a swear word. It's in Shakespeare.
I don't expect you to use...
Let's get on with it. You just pulled me up on blue lights and suggested to me that I'm a criminal. So let's crack on with it.
So I didn't say you were a criminal.
Why are you on blue lights?
I didn't say you were a criminal.
What do you want?
That's how it's been graded.
Tell me what you want.
Right. So I would like to find out who you are firstly.
Okay. Well, that's not going to happen, is it?
And why you're taking photos of the military establishment.
And where are your friends? Oh, here they are. Just the three of you, or are you waiting for more backup?
More backup for what, sir?
For me, it's obviously three. Does it need three of you?
Well, no, but we're in the
area. Because I've got a camera.
We were in the area at the time. So they
okay,
sent
all right.
Various units, don't
so you
they?
Both come on blue lights, did you?
They sent. They
right,
sent
what do you want?
Response,
you're not
they?
Getting my name. I don't have to tell you what I'm doing because I'm protected by Human Rights Privacy Act, okay? Article 8.
That's okay.
I'm not doing anything unlawful. I've never left the public footpath.
No.
No it's not against
no,
the law what
no
I'm doing.
No one's saying you are, but you shouldn't be taking pictures of a military establishment.
Wrong. Wrong. Be careful what you say to me, because if you start giving me directives, you can take it through a gate if the gate has mesh on it. Mm-hmm. If they don't want people taking photographs through the mesh, then what they do is they put planks on there.
But your action could be considered...
No, don't go down that road, because then I will ask you for more evidence. I'll ask you for credible and current intelligence that would suggest that. And you wouldn't be able to provide anything, would you? All you've got at the moment is a member of the public with a camera.
Mm-hmm. We have. But
so what do you want to do about it?
They've obviously raised
I don't care what they say.
Stage,
I don't care.
They?
Their jurisdiction is in there. I don't give a
because
shit.
Because we don't know who you are.
Well, so what? I don't know who you are now, do I?
You do, because I've just given you...
You haven't given me your name.
I don't,
well, give us your driving licence. Let me know who you are and where you live.
I'm not required to.
I'm not required to give you mine.
But you are if I think you're committing a criminal offence.
What's the offence?
At this stage...
What's the offence?
At this stage, we're
what's
yet
the
to
offense?
Establish that, aren't we?
What's the offence?
But I want to know who you are
what's
and
the
what
offense?
You're doing at this level.
Then I tell you what, once you've got the offence, then you can have my name.
I'm just asking you to stop and account for your actions, sir. At this stage.
I don't account for a lawful activity, and neither should anybody. Tell me the offence, and I'll give you my name. Detain me or arrest me, and I'll give you my name.
I'm not arresting you, am I? Because I don't know whether there's
okay.
an offence being committed.
Well, then why aren't you coming here on blue
because
lights
my,
and talking to me? I think we're done, aren't
moment,
we?
Sir, are down there chatting with the people...
No, they're not. They're behind you.
No, they're not. There's two or three cars here. There's another car down there. Isn't
for
there?
God's
there's
sake.
At the base, isn't there?
You've got three cars here for a photographer. I'm a detained.
Sorry?
I'm a detained.
I'm not detained you at the moment.
See you later, all right. Prove a point. You learnt a lesson today, boys. The lesson is that we're allowed to do this. You're protecting my rights. You shouldn't be giving me a hard time. Your first three did. Why haven't they phoned the police then? Why have we had three police cars turn up for a camera? You see how silly it is? You should be, I'm paying for you to protect me and my rights. Surely that's what you joined up for. Am I wrong? You just turn up for the money? You like to say hello to any friends while you're on? Any requests? Okay, I'll leave you in peace. Hopefully I've proved a point.
Have a good day.
Focus, focus! Just about to get arrested! Afternoon, ladies. What are we on? What are we on today? Are we working or are we just sitting around?
Oh, we're always working.
Oh, good man.
Yeah, how are you?
Fantastic. Yeah, wonderful, actually.
Yeah, nice day.
It is, isn't it?
Yeah, not bad at all.
You having a good day?
It's going all right, actually.
Pictures at the MOD centre.
That's right, yeah.
Anything in particular or...?
Everything.
Everything?
Oh. Yeah.
That's the only thing for us, because we don't
Let's get a
that.
Shot of you.
Yeah.
Okay.
What's it you like about the sort of TA centres?
What does it say I liked it?
What's that?
I didn't say I liked it.
You didn't like it?
Why are you taking photos? You've got an interest or something, haven't you?
Well, I couldn't say I like it.
Oh, no, but an interest.
I take pictures of my kids, but I don't like them.
All right, fair enough.
Fair enough.
But, so we just that's all we're coming to report of.
Give them a wave. Let me crew.
Oh, yeah, your fans, are they?
Give us a wave!
Right, what are we doing, lads? I'm a busy man. Can't be standing around talking to you three all day. And I know you've got a McDonald's to go to.
Oh, no.
The only reason we've come out here is obviously we're Ministry of Defence Police.
Right,
someone,
well done.
Someone sighted you. Well, someone's got to do it. Someone sighted you down at the Army Reserve Centre.
Hold on. Yeah. So again, how many's come out? One, two, three, four, five, six, seven officers come out. Four on camera.
It's the security,
it could have been an ambush because it could have been two cameras.
Well, it is two cameras. Got one on
your you're right. It is, yeah.
Yeah.
And one there.
Yeah,
no, and one on the other side. Yeah. Four cameras.
Well, saying, we're here because we responded to a report that they were taking a photo of a
fantastic
establishment.
What crime's that?
It was all fine.
What crime is that?
Oh, there is no crime. You're in a public domain and you can take photos. Again, for us, it's a security risk.
Is it?
We're here to engage with people. Now, we're not here to stop you from doing it, but we'll always ask why people are here, and you don't have to answer our questions either.
But that's just as well, because I'm not.
And that's the thing. But obviously, as you'll appreciate, with the modern terrorist climate, we have to be careful around mod establishments.
Really?
And we have to come out here. And especially with the Ministry of Defence Police, that's kind of our remit, to keep these sites protected.
Why do you say under the modern terrorism?
It's always been the same.
It's always been the same for like the last 100 years, hasn't it?
Well, it has been, but unfortunately...
120 years, actually.
Well, completely agree, but now it's going more cyber and technology-based.
Yeah.
Cameras, photos, bits and pieces. Again, you could do your reconnaissance online, then come down here in person.
Exactly.
What we're here
or
for
not come down here.
Sure.
You could just do it online and not come down here, couldn't you?
And we just want to show that there is a reaction. If people can drop up here and they have any horrible intentions, we turn up.
Yeah.
And if you publish these pictures online, I don't know what you're going to do with them. Anyone that is doing any reconnaissance will suddenly go, I've taken a few pictures and all these police rocked up.
Right,
the greatest way to deter people is by you publicly resisting.
Okay.
Yeah, we've got a driver.
He's got an easy job, hasn't he?
Yeah, he just drives us around.
Try and stay awake, mate.
But do you have a YouTube channel at all?
I can't answer questions like that.
I just wonder if I'm going to end up on YouTube. I might be able to...
You probably will be if you just type in Three Handsome Guys, Plymouth. That's what it's going to be. Yeah. It was the other three I've talked to, actually. No, I'm only kidding.
Now, I'll ask, and again, as I said, you don't have to answer my question, but would I be able to get your name off you at all?
No, why would you want to? Why would you want to collect intelligence on a member of the public? You never joined up. You never said to your mum and dad, I'm going to join the police, mum, because you know what I want to do? I want to go up to people that aren't breaking the law and collect data on them so they can go on the National Police computer, and then what they can do is they can be part of all the misconduct hearings that we get every month where they're predominantly police abusing the National Computer. Does that answer your question?
No, as I said, you don't have to answer my question.
Okay.
Next thing I'll ask.
I thought I had.
But you haven't answered it in the way I was expecting.
Okay.
Now, next I'm going to ask, are you likely to go to any of the mod establishments to take any further pictures today? Because if you are, I will pass your description over.
Well, that's no good, is it?
You won't get this sudden reaction because I don't want to impact your day by restricting your liberty by stopping you constantly.
You don't. You provide me with consent.
Okay, that's fine.
The worst thing would have been if you'd have just ignored me. If you'd have turned the other way, which is the story of my life, really. If you'd just driven past and we'd have been like two chips in the night. Yeah. It would have been awful.
For me, it's just engaging with people. I'm here to be friendly, you're here to be friendly.
I am.
Again, unfortunately, there is sometimes a clash of personalities between people, but I'm here to be professional, and I don't want that to get in the way. Again, I'm not here to stop you, but I am here to engage with you.
How do you get that cut on your nose? Has somebody hit you there?
No, it's not because of their face masks. I see, right, okay. I'm a relatively charming person, but I do have a plentiful face.
Well. Even after COVID's over, they're going to keep you wearing the mask, aren't they?
Hide my ugly mug, it's absolutely fine.
I hate this, you know, when somebody walks away and goes, has the inspector sorted it? Yeah, have you found anything that we can get him on? Well, we can do section 50 if you want. Yeah, we can try that. No, I tell you what, there's a woman here at the bus stop, she's looking alarmed and distressed. We can do him actually public order. Is that what's going on there?
No, not so.
Okay.
Before,
is it? Oh, yeah, it's a well-known routine.
Do you go all around the country, do you?
I'm working down here, so I thought I'd just come and have a look around while I'm here.
Yeah, fair enough. How long are you down here for?
I'd be answering questions, wouldn't it?
You know.
Oh, you're a weasel, you are. I can see what you're doing. You're weaseling your way in.
Well, it's likely if you'd be here as well, we'd get another call on the police, then, aren't you?
Well, listen, next time you come, bring some at work. Bring something to the party.
Yeah?
Bring some chocolates or donuts or whatever.
Oh, COVID times can't be doing
you,
that.
You three don't look like you eat donuts, though. Not as much as me. Yeah.
Thanks for noticing.
They don't let me.
So what are we doing today, guys? What time are you on till? Well, whatever time we can finish, really. We're out and about all day, doing our project transfer.
Now, listen, there's a rumour going around that what happens is, if you're on till, say, 2 o'clock, you find a little job at about 10 to 2 that will take you to 20 past 2, and then you'll be in overtime. Is that right? Does that ever happen?
Not from it. If we see something happening in the department, we need to act upon it, we have to act upon it, don't we?
Right. So, it was another copper that said that.
Yeah.
He said what he used to do is, just near to him coming off his shift, he used to find somebody on the street who was bound to have a little bit of cannabis on them, and then, because it was fast and done with and over, it just took him over. Is it 15 or 16 minutes, is it, over the hour that you get overtime?
For us, we've got to do a bit longer than that.
Oh, right, okay.
But obviously we can't comment on what other officers do, but if it's preventing crime, then it's doing something other
yeah.
What the public want us to do.
Yeah.
So
perhaps that's what he was doing, he was just being vigilant close to his time off.
Ones we've got.
Yeah.
Who knows? But you've got a good old setup there, haven't you, on that camera?
It's nice, isn't it?
Can't be cheap.
But no. But they're doing away with them.
Are they?
The SLRs getting rid of them. So this is probably gonna be the last ones on the line.
Would you sell it? Would it be worth a lot of money?
No, I don't actually. I'm a bit of a hoarder. Yeah. Got all sorts of. I have about 20 phone leads at home that will never ever be used again, but I just can't throw them out.
Yeah. Just in case.
You must be the same.
Yeah, everyone likes to hoard some stuff, don't they?
Have you got your man drawer?
What, of rubbish?
All stuff in the man drawer, yeah.
I think everyone's got one of those. But like I say, we're not doing anything wrong, so we're
okay.
But, probably see you around if you can be around a while.
Yeah.
Photos.
Yeah.
Hope you get some good spots.
Yeah.
Enjoy.
Now, the only thing I request from you, the only thing I want from you, is that the army personnel were all up in arms doing this and through the gate and demanding to know. Now, I know their jurisdiction is constrained to the premises that they're on, but it is a little bit annoying because they put up a mesh fence and they put light trucks in there that need photographing. And then they whinge at you when you do it. Now, then people are being employed by my money to fight for my rights. So when they then phone the police and you all come out, because it's a waste of police time, when you come out, it's not good. You know, that the fact.
Were you wearing your battle card
wrap? I was wearing this, yeah, I was wearing my COVID mask.
Because if you're on your own wearing your battle card wrap, it's sort of like, well, why is he wearing that? Because
no.
So it's not COVID related.
Well,
so they might be feeling a bit threatened themselves. So.
Well, can I correct you on that by saying there are plenty of videos pre-COVID where similar things have happened. So it's nothing to do with the mask.
Yeah, okay.
It's a little bit like when somebody films the back of the police station and the police come out and say, you're suspicious filming the back of the station. And then you realise that same thing would happen if you're filming the front.
Yeah, you've got to find out. That's why we're here to engage, to find out if you're being suspicious or if you're just taking pure interest in what happens. That's all we're inquiring about.
Is this the cavalry?
No, this is Devon and Cornwall unit. They're probably just finding out.
Oh, is this the first guy I talked with?
Yeah, I'll go.
Yeah, all right. Listen, guys, it's been great.
Yeah.
It's been great talking to you.
For your YouTube or wherever you put it.
Yeah. Sure. Have a good day.
You, sir.
Stay safe. Let's get a shot of that as well. What are you now? Servitors?
Project Servitor.
It's a national initiative, so it's rolling out across the country.
Oh, yeah, yeah. See something, say something, do now. Is that it?
I wouldn't say do now. it's trying to build that public engagement again. Anything you want to talk to us, engage us about, we're there en masse. We'll flood an area with high visibility coppers at random times of the day, at random locations. It deters local crime. And it just builds up the intelligence, which I think was just sadly lacking, because unfortunately the relationship between the police and the public has degraded over
it's
the last
terrible.
Couple of years, and COVID has made that worse in my opinion. But we're here to try and build it better, and that's just by engaging.
Why do you think it's bad?
I think it's the perception, unfortunately.
Well, it's not the perception, because it's like on every inquiry that is held regarding the police comes out with you looking like shit. Not you two, but the police. So it can't be perception.
People
every week,
the whole, don't they? Rather than
we have to.
Different officers.
And every week there is a headline, and it's either the worst is the Wayne Cousins, but you've got the paedophiles, you've got the there's all sorts every week.
It's the small minority, and I mean small minority, ruining it for the rest of us.
We're in a position of trust, and they're breaking that trust. So that is the difference. Where we're trying to install you know, that back from the public, that people like that have actually just smashed everything that we've built.
Yeah.
And they've just made it, you know, hard work for us. Because people don't come and talk to us. We miss a lot of stuff. By just talking to people, you might build up intelligence or get information that will help towards something. You're not getting a good sort of information that we can act on.
Yeah.
And that's how we can deter crime. So that's what we're trying to do, just get out in these areas, talk to people, look for people, yeah, that they're trying to avoid us. Yeah, we'll pick up on them as well. But there usually is a reason for them avoiding us. So mainly it's trying to get back that trust of people coming up to us. So they want to call us, but they can come and have a chat with us if they want. So,
well, you two have been great with me. So I'm going to leave you in peace.
Yeah.
And
the one thing I'll warn you, just before you go.
Oh.
Obviously, if you do go to the mod sites,
yeah.
The Ministry of Defence Police, we are, as we're part of the unarmed asset,
yeah.
We are quite flexible. You may bump into us again. We're not tracking you. We're not following you. But if you go to another mod site and it raises alarm for them and they contact the police,
okay.
You may find that we just end up rocking up.
Right.
It's just because we are the available asset that will be on today at most of the
time. We'll have a check with them as well. So.
All right. So will you relay that information back to the army as well?
Yeah.
And I'll crack on.
Yeah.
And I'll go and find another MOD base. See you later, guys.
See you later.
Stay cool. Stay cool. See you, mate.